Good morning, children. So everybody ready? So with today we start with exercise 1.2. So please open exercise 1.2, page number 9 in your textbook. Okay. So first one is, write down a pair of integers whose sum is -7. Okay. Sum is -7. Now, what is the meaning of sum? Sum means addition. So now we have to write a pair of integers. So pair of integers means we have to select two integers in such a way that when we add those two integers, we get the answer as -7. Okay. Now there can be many integers, right? There can be many integers, but here we can write the answer as, suppose if I write -10 and 3. Now these are the two integers, -10 and 3. Both are integers, and when I add it, -10 plus 3, I get the answer as -7. Okay. And another example if I want to take, suppose second example, can anybody tell me any two integers, and when I add those two integers, I should get the answer as -7. Okay. So can anybody tell me, suppose if I take -17. Okay. So if I take -17 as one integer and another integer if I take as 10. So -17 plus 10, I get the answer as -7. Okay. So whenever such situation is given, you can get many examples. Okay. You can write many examples. So in exam also, it is not necessary that you have to write -10 and 3 only. You can select any numbers, but just you have to keep in mind that when you add those two integers, your answer should be -7. Understood? Okay, fine. Now see the second one. Difference is -10. Difference. Now what is the meaning of difference? Difference means subtraction. So I have to select any two integers in such a way that when I subtract one integer from another, I should get the answer as -10. Again, that is the same situation over here, children. You can have many, many, many examples. Okay, but we will just write one or two. Okay, so difference is -10. So if I select -6 and 4. Okay, if I select -6 and 4, and if I do the difference, difference means -6, -4. So -6, -4 is -10. Similarly, another example if I want to take, I can take as -5 and 5. So -5, -5, right? Answer will be again -10. Okay, now the third one. Sum is 0. Sum is 0. Okay. Can you give me the examples? Very easy. Can you give me the example of two integers that when I add, the answer will be 0? Yes. The additive inverse. Suppose if I take 3, then 3 and minus 3. Right? So if I take minus 3 and 3. So minus 3 plus 3. 0. Okay. Second answer. Second example. Anybody? Yes. I can write as, suppose -15 and 15. So -15 plus 15 is equal to 0. Like that way. Okay. So when you have to select two integers whose sum are zeros, then you have to take the additive inverse of the numbers. -3 then 3. -15, 15. -10 and 10. Okay. Understood? So that was question number 1. Now see question number 2. It is this way only, but here the situation is given to you. You have to write the integers, you have to find the integers provided the situation. Now let us see. Question number 2. negative integers whose difference is 8. Now here you are given that you have to write a pair of negative integers, means whichever two integers I select, both of them should be negative. Okay, so I have to select two negative integers whose difference is 8. Negative integers, pair of negative integers whose difference is 8. Okay, so what can I say? Whose difference is 8. So I can select as minus 2 and minus 10. Right? Minus 2 and minus 10. How? So that when I take the difference, that is minus 2 minus minus 10, that is equal to minus 2 plus 10, that is equal to 8. Is that clear? Two negative integers whose difference, means the negative integer and their difference, when I solve it, I get the answer as 8. Is that clear? Okay. Now see the second one. Write a negative integer and a positive integer whose sum is minus 5. Write a pair of negative integer and positive integer whose sum is minus 5. Whose sum is minus. Sum means I have to perform the addition. Right? So if I take minus 6 and 1, then when I solve it, whose sum is so I take a negative integer, pair of negative integer and positive integer. So I have taken a negative integer, I have taken a positive integer, and when I have taken the sum, I get the answer as minus 5. Is that clear? Okay. Now see the next one. Here the situation is given, so you have to solve according to the situation. If the situation is not given, as in question number 1, you are just told that write down two integers. Now it can be both negative, it can be both positive, one negative, one positive, that you have to decide, right? But the thing is that in question number 2, the situation is given to you, so you have to solve according to the situation. Okay, now see the next one. Write a negative integer and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3. Negative integer and positive integer. Negative integer and positive integer whose difference is minus 3. Right? So what will be the answer? One should be negative and one should be positive. Right? So suppose if I take minus 1 and 2. So minus 1 minus 2, that is equal to minus 1 minus 2, that is equal to minus 3. Okay? So one negative integer and one positive integer, and when I take its difference, you get the answer as minus 3. Is that clear? So we stop here. Your homework is question number 1 and 2 of exercise 1.2. Okay children, so in the next period, we will finish the question number 3 and 4, and if possible, we will start new topic. Till then, just finish 1 and 2 in your notebook. And please, children, write in neat and clean handwriting. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.